गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड शास्त्री अलगदम, इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट ऑफ शास्त्री अलगदम विच इज used to generate the hash code. Okay, for an arbitrary length message, it is going to generate a fixed length code. Like, unlike other algorithms, SHA-1, SHA-2 will produce a fixed length code, whereas SHA-3 will produce a step-by-step procedure. Means, it is going to take the data, arbitrary length data, and in a step-by-step manner, it is going to produce the hash code. Means, it uses absorbing and squeezing phases. So, it will absorb as much data as possible. And then, in the squeezing phase, it is going to produce the hash code. So, in the first squeeze, it can produce some fixed length code, hash code. And then, and again, if we perform squeeze operation over the SHA-3 algorithm, again it will produce the some hash code, some, fixed length code hash code. So here step-by-step procedure will be done. So already we discussed the history of SHA-3 algorithm, which is developed in 2015. The major it was developed by using the KKAC rule. So it uses two functions, absorbing phase, two phases, absorbing phase and the squeezing phase. And we have also seen the block diagram of the SHA-3. I mean, this absorbing phase and the squeezing phase, this can be represented as the sponge function. Sponge function or the sponge construction. So entire message will be first, in any algorithms, hash function algorithms, message will be added because it is going to divide the message into some fixed length blocks. So in order to make it as a fixed length block, what it is going to do is it is going to pack some bits in order to make a perfect block size, L number of blocks. L number of blocks. Then it is going to, so here once it is going to take the input in between, before going to produce the output, it's going to apply the SHA-3 algorithm. Here the output is simply, it is going to get in a step-by-step manner. So here in first space, it is going to produce R bits information. Again, it is going to produce again R bits information. Like that, it is going to perform. So this is the structure of the sponge construction or the structure of SHA-3 algorithm. Simply, it uses one function. We call it as iterative function. Iterative function, and this is some state variable. S is some state variable. So what it is going to do is the function will take two parameters. Two inputs. So first step is it is going to take the message. So it is going to take R bit message, R bit length message. So if you observe the block diagram, every plaintext block is of R bits. So that will be considered. Along with that R bit message, some capacity will be added. So in order to provide the security, more security to the SHA-3 algorithm, this capacity will be added. So again, this capacity is nothing but simply it is going to take the zeros, okay, a number of zeros. So the capacity this will take whatever the R bit length message is there. So if capacity is increased, if number of zeros are increased, then R will be reduced. If the capacity is decreased, the size of the capacity is less, and then R will be increased. At the end, both r plus c value should be 1600 bits. Okay, r plus c value will consist of the 1600 bits. So this will be given. So first P0 is nothing but first clock that will be given, and it will be performed XOR operation will be performed. So for the first step, so here XOR operation will be performed with this again the message block R. So here it will be performed XOR operation with all zeros. Initially it will perform XOR operation with all zeros. How many number of zeros is 1600 zeros, because the length of message with the capacity is 1600, and it performs the round function or iterative function. After performing the iterative function, that will give the state variable. Yes, now from second round onwards, the state variable is as well as the next block of the message will be the inputs to perform the XOR operation. So it will be continued to some extent, like it performs the n number of rounds in the absorbing phase. And finally, whatever the result is produced, that is the state array will be produced, that will be given to the squeezing phase. So from that phase, it is going to generate the output. It is going to generate the output, that is the hash code. Hash code will be generated. So the size of that is, again, that for Shatri algorithm, the size of the output varies. Means sometimes it can produce 224 bit output or hash code, or sometimes it can produce 384 bits output hash code. Sometimes it produces the 512 bits hash code. So this is the algorithm, the pseudocode for sponge construction, both the observing phase as well as the squeezing phase. What are the inputs and how it is going to process by taking the XOR operation. Internally, round function or iterative function will be applied. We'll see what is iterative. So this one, S is equals to f of s. What is this iterative function? We'll see that. In the parameters also already we discussed. So message digest size, output, this is the output of the Shatri. So 224 bits, it can produce 224 bits output, or 256, 384 or 512 bits output will be produced. Input will be any length, no maximum size, unlimited message will be considered bitrate. So as I said, this R plus C value should be 1600. According to that, if the capacity is less, obviously the size of the message so will be more. And so here the Shatri algorithm will have all the properties of the hash function. Hash function has different properties, like a collision resistance, weak collision, weak hash collision property, strong collision, all are there, right? So here it uses the iteration function. We'll see how the iteration function will be performed. So iteration function takes 1600 bit input. So if you observe this block diagram, so f is the iteration function, this one. This is the iterative function, which is taking two inputs. Or if you observe, initially it is going to take all zeros as well as the message. If we take some ith function, iterative function, this is some ith iterative function. This f is taking two inputs, right? One is the p1 plus p1, that is message block, and 0 power c, that is message. Small p1 is nothing but the message. This 0 power c is nothing but the capacity bits, zeros, number of zeros. The length is c. And the second input is, yes, that is the variable. It is going to produce some the output of the previous block, previous round. So that will be the input to the round function, iteration function. It produces the output. So this output again will be used for the next function. Like any other SHA algorithms, it uses the function. So how this iteration function will be represented as, so we'll see the representation. Okay, so we'll see the representation of the iteration function. So iteration function will take the input from the state variable s as well as the plain text message. So what is the state variable contains? State variable is the output of the previous round. So how the data will be stored in a state variable is, it will be stored in the form of 5x5x64. It will be stored in a three-dimensional array. Okay, state variable data will be stored in a three-dimensional array where the number of rows, five columns, five, and number of lanes, we call it as the lanes, or will be 64. So array will be represented with A of X, Y, Z. Okay, so it uses, so here maximum, so 5x5 matrix will be there. Maximum number of rows are 5, maximum number of columns are 5 again, and the lane will have the 64 bits. So rows starts from 0 to 4 and the column starts from, actually this X represents the, generally whenever we take array, first one represents the row, second one represents the column, whereas here the X represents, so if it is, the lane is represented with this L, so X is the column and the Y is the row, and the entire lane, so here it uses 5x5x64 dimension matrix, right? So the 5x5x64 where it is going to take the index from 0 to 63. The Z will take index from 0 to 63. Okay, so the array A, which is having the three indexes like X, Y, Z, will be represented as the state variable with S will be represented like this. I mean, whatever the value is there in this particular lane will be represented as 64 of 5x plus z. Whatever the value is there, I mean, x may be any row. It may be first row or second row. So that row value, column value, and y is the row. The row value will be considered, and it will be multiplied with, the row will be multiplied with 5, and that will be, the entire thing will be multiplied with 64, and the z value will be added. Z value from 0 to 63. So here, this is the representation of the state matrix. So state matrix will have the three-dimensional matrix. So here, X is the column. So from 0 to 4, because it is a 5x5x64 matrix. And Y is the row. So here, the lowest, the last row indicates the first, in this table, row index starts from the last row. So here row index, that is y is equals to 0 is the first row of the lane, and y is equals to 4 is the last row. Here this particular cell specifies L of 0,4 means this is the first column and the last row. And every lane, so internally, so here there are totally, if we represent this with a 5x5 matrix, it will have totally 25 internally. Every lane, so every cell internally will have the 64 bits. Okay, every cell will have 64 bits. So the 64 bits will be represented with. So whatever, suppose if there is L of, suppose if we consider this one, L of 0,0. If we consider L of 0,0, so this L of 0,0 will have 64 bits. So here it can be represented, these 64 can be represented like this. So L of X, Y, 0 means X is 0, Y is 0,0, and X is 0, Y is 0, 1. So like that, A of 0063 will be reproduced. Internally, every cell will have the 64 bits of information. This is the state matrix, the state variable, which is in the SHA algorithm block diagram, which will be represented as the state variable. Yes, so that will be given to the given as input to the next round. Okay. So here L of 00 will be the first row as well as the first column, and internally it will have the 64 bits of information we just now discussed. And L of 10 means one is nothing but column. This is not row. One means column. That is second column and first row. Again, it will have the 64 bits of information. And here, this function, iteration function, internally will have some five steps. It performs some five steps, where the five steps will take different types of operations. So here, 1600 bit input state variable, so which will be represented in a 5x5 matrix, and then the total this SHA-3 algorithm will take 24 rounds, means 24 times the function iteration will be performed. In each round, it is going to have internally. So this function f will consist of five steps. It will consist of five steps. What are these five steps? Means simply all these five steps. What are the state? Actually, this function will take the state array. I mean state variable as well as the plain text message, right? Message will be considered, which is having the message and the capacity. Message is nothing but including the capacity. So by taking these two input values, what it is going to do is internally it performs five steps. What the five steps are, simply five steps will perform some permutations as well as the substitutions over the data. So here it is taking 1600 data bits data, and it is also giving the 1600 bit data. So by taking this data of perfect operation between these two, it will be given, right? So that data will be given to step one. Inside this, step one will be there, step two, step three, step four, step five will be there. So step one will perform some permutations or substitutions. Step two will perform some permutations or substitutions over the 1600 bit data. So we'll see what are the different types of operations. So here it performs, all five steps will perform only permutations and the substitutions. So all the rounds are identical. So total there are 24 rounds, right? The function f will be performed in 24 rounds. So all 23 rounds will be the same. So and each round will use the some round constant. Round constant will be used, like in SHA-512 algorithm, round constant is used, right? In SHA-53, cube root of first 80 prime numbers are used as the round constant. In 80 rounds, so SHA-3 has 80 rounds. So here also, round constant will be used. And simply, it uses five steps. So one function is a theta function, one is a row function, row. So this is called as a row function. This is called as a pi function. This is C function, like that. There are different types of functions. So these are all the notations which are used to represent the function. So this is some iota function. So we'll see the names of the functions and the structure of the functions. And what all these functions will be performed. Internal procedure is simply it performs some operations like Boolean operations, XOR operation, and NOT operations will be performed, and some rotations, means left shift and right shift operations will be performed. no other operations like addition, subtraction will not be performed. Simply it performs the XOR operations logical, and not and left shift right shift will be performed. And here Shatrughan implemented using the hardware of the software. So here these are the five functions: theta function, row function. So as I said, all these functions are used to perform only substitutions and the permutation. So among all these five functions, theta function, and say function performs addition. Pi function performs the permutation again. You know, right? What is a substitution? What is a permutation? Substitution means simply a bit will be replaced with some other bit. Okay. Whereas in permutation, simply whatever the text is there, that will be rearranged. Rearrangement will be happened either by left shift or right shift. Rearrangement will be done. So it may apply n number of left shifts, or it can perform left shift on n number of bits, like that permutation will be happened. Again, pi function, the third function is pi function, applies the permutations. And the next function, the chi function, CHI, performs the substitution. And this last one, the symbol, this is iota function, we'll see. It performs the substitution. So how it is going to perform the substitution, the details we'll see. Yes, iterative function is going to, so total 24 iterative rounds will be there. So in each round, I mean, from round zero to round 23. So here it is going to apply first among all these functions, pi functions, first theta will be applied, then row function will be applied, then pi function, then chi function will be applied, then iota will be applied. And all these functions are taking input from the previous function itself. If you observe, theta is going to take input from the state array, that is, which is 5 by 5 by 64, isn't it? Which is right, and the output of theta will be given to the row. This row function is making use of some input. Okay, it's making use of input, and the last one, iota, is also using some input. What is that? Iota is using some input, that is the RC is nothing but round constant. As I said, there will be a round constant. So round constant will be used in the last function of the iteration function. So totally it is going to use 24 round constants, from round constant 0 to round constant 23. So finally it is going to produce the state array again. So this will be given to the squeezing phase of the sponge construction. And what is this theta function specifies? Theta step function is, it is going to take input from where? Theta function is going to take input from the state array or the state matrix. Yes, right, it's going to take input from the, yes. So here that is represented with a three-dimensional matrix, that is represented with a of x, y, z, right? That will be given to the input to the theta. So it takes column X, row Y, and also Z value will be there from 0 to 23. So this theta function, the formula for this theta function is, so every bit will, A of X, Y, Z will be, how the bit will be computed is by applying this formula. Simply, it applies the formula. So whatever the bit is there, existing bit is there, that existing bit will be performed XOR operation. It performs the XOR operation with the remaining thing. This A of XYZ will be performed the XOR with this one. So here this is the summation of the other bits which are there in the array. So what it is going to take, simply it is going to take a of x minus 1. Suppose if the corresponding bit, the location, I mean, if you take the array some second row, second row means index will be 1, then a of x minus 1 will be 0, like that. It is going to take, there are totally 5 rows, isn't it? It is a 5 by 5 by 64 array. So it applies the summation over the bits on x, y, z, three dimensions of data will be considered, and the result after applying this formula, whatever the result is, that will be stored in this particular location. That bit value will be stored in that particular location. And so in order to apply this, internally it is going to use, in between the summations, it is going to use the XOR operations. XOR operation, right? So here it takes, what it is going to do is, first it is going to consider the XOR operation over the different columns, over the over the different rows. So from zero, first row, second row, third row, fourth row, it is going to take the values of different rows and performs the XOR operation. Then that will be used in the theta notation. And so here, in order to get the value of a of x, y, z, what it is going to do, it is going to take a particular column and the row, and it is going to perform the XOR operation. See, it is going to perform the XOR operation between the lanes. Means between every row, it is going to perform the XOR operation. And whatever the computed value is there, so that computed value will be used in the lane where it is going to have the representation is from 0 to 63. And so here, in order to produce the particular bit using the theta notation, so here it is applying the two summations. This is one summation, and here also it is going to use another summation. So again, so it is going to perform the XOR operation by using the particular position. See, here whatever the bit it is going to consider, so Z value will start from 0 to 63. Whatever the current bit it is going to compute, it is going to take the previous bit, and for column, it is going to take the next column. Like that, it is going to take the values and it produces. And also, it produces some, it applies some rotation, like circular right shift will be applied. Circular right shift will be applied, and it will produce the value of A of X, Y, Z. So here, this is the representation. So if we consider one particular cell in the lane, so which is a 5 by 5 matrix, right? So L of 2, 3 means second column, third column and fourth row. So this one. So this is a third column and this is the fourth row, because row starts from the 0. So how it is going to compute is, simply it is going to compute using this one. C of 1 XOR operation, and whatever the value is there in this particular lane, that will be applied XOR operation with rotation. It is going to apply the rotation. Circular right shift rotation will be applied. Okay, so here how many times? This 1 is nothing but how many times it is going to apply the rotation. So this C value will be calculated from this formula. So C of X will be calculated like this. So for which column we are going to compute the C value. So we need to take that column. X is nothing but, suppose we are going to take for second column, then so it will be represented as C of 1. So that is the procedure of the first function, that is theta function. And the second function is the row function. So which is a subset of iteration function. So the symbol row will be represented by using the symbol. And the formula how a particular value will be calculated in a particular position of that state array is a of x, y, z will be represented as a of x, y, z if both x and y belongs to zero. I mean, if it belongs to first row and first column, then it will not change the bit value. But if it is not, if it does not belongs to any first row, then it applies the formula. This formula will be applied: a of x comma y comma z minus t plus 1 into t plus 2 by 2, where t value ranges between 0 to 23. 0 to 23 will be there. Simply, it is going to take this matrix 0, 1, 2, 3, and it applies the power, whatever the value it is going to take for t, and it will be multiplied with 1, 0. Okay, it will be multiplied with 1, 0. And then it produces the value. So that is the row function. So here is a description for the row function. Plane position is x, y, 0 means first row. L of 0, 0 means first row. Unaffected, will not modify the bit value. Okay, if it is not belongs to the first row, then it is going to perform the circular bit shift. Okay, because row function is a which type of one? Row function is a permutation. If you observe the table, row function is a permutation. Permutation means it is simply changing the position of the bits. How it is going to change the position? By applying the rotations, like circular right shift and all. So here it is going to apply the circular bit shift. That is, the right shift will be applied. Okay, so it is going to take the values, t value will be 0 to 24, and once it takes a value, then it is going to use this formula. It will use the formula, this formula, and produces the output. This is the row function. And so this, there is an example. So if t value is 3, and if you want to compute the x, y value, simply this is a constant array matrix. 0, 1, 2, 3 is a constant matrix, and 1, 0 will be multiplied with the 1, 0. So power 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, power 3 will be multiplied. That will be multiplied 3 times. Then will be multiplied with 1, 0. Then mod 5 will be applied. Finally, whatever the result is there, so that will be given. Okay. That will be given as a so here it is going to take x and y values, right? How the x and y values will be this, what after computing. So by taking the t value, after computing whatever it gets the x and y values, that value will be substituted. It is not going to directly substitute that x and y value. Okay. So here, in order to get the except for the first row, in order to get the values, the x and y values, how it is going to become, because all are the static matrices, like 0, 1, 2, 3 is a static, and 1, 0 is a static, and based on the t value. So we know that t starts from 0 to the last value t is 23. Okay, so the corresponding values, because g value z, this one, z minus t into 1 plus, I mean t plus 1 into t plus 2 by 2. So this value, so if it is, if t value is 1, 0, what will be the result? T value is 1 or t value is 2, till t value is 23. So this table is having all the values. So once it is calculating the value, it will apply mod with the 64, because the length of the matrix is 64. The contain among A of X, Y, Z, 5 rows, 5 columns, and there will be Z lines. And so once it gets the values of X and Y, then it is going to get the Z value. So in order to get this Z value, it is going to apply. Next, so here this entire row function is going to perform the permutations only, and then so this permutation will provide the diffusion. So diffusion means the main purpose is it has to provide a strong hash code. So once a hash code is generated, so I mean, for a given plain text, hash code will be generated. So one should not identify. So diffusion is simply nothing but once it is generated, so small modifications in the ciphertext will not will get a lot of difference in the bits of the plain text. So that will be provided using this row function. And the third function is the pi function. Third step function is pi function. So this is a formula for the pi function. A of x y is a of x dash y dash, where it is going to take the same matrix 0, 1, 2, 3, the constant, and it is going to take the values. And it is going to multiply with the matrix, the given matrix. So here, in order to represent this pi function, I mean, in order to get which value it is going to consider. So here, it is going to represent the entire plane will be in this format. So there are 5 rows. And 5 columns. Okay, and these will be represented in this manner. Before going to perform the pi step, the lane will be represented in this format from 0 to. So after performing the step, after performing the pi function, so it is modified to. Because row function, pi function is also which type of function? Permutation. Simply, it is going to rearrange the bits. Okay, it is not going to substitute. Instead, it is going to rearrange. All the values which are present here will be present over the after the pi function. Okay, simply it uses this. Next function is the T function, the representation, the symbol which is used is, so here it is a substitution function. T function is a, among all the functions, so T function is a substitution function. So in order to substitute with some value, it is going to perform the XOR operation. So using so here using this one, so one bit will be modified or the replaced with the bit initially whatever the bit it is going to take the column here x, it is going to take the column value will be XORed with the next column, and that will be XORed. First it is going to perform, so whatever the column, suppose if you are going to take the second column, then third column will be XORed with value 1, with value 1. Third column will be XORed with 1, and then it is going to perform the logical AND operation with fourth column. The entire result will be XORed with the second column itself. So this procedure will be applied. This will be applied. So here it is going to apply only substitution over the column. it is not going to change the row value and the lane value. Simply it is going to change substituting the column value. Now the last function function, the representation, how it is going to represent. This is the representation. And the last function is iota function. So this is the formula for the iota function. Simply whatever the bit is there, it is going to perform XOR with the round constant. So if there is the function will be performed from 0 to 23, total 24 rounds will be there. Suppose if it is performed in ith round, so ith round constant will be performed XOR with the that particular matrix, the state matrix, I mean the output of the previous function, that is chi function. Simply it performs the XOR operation because it is also a substitution function. Iota step function is a substitution function. Okay. And so whenever it is going to be the round constant will be given, right? So total 24 round constants will be there. So which round constant value will be given to the first round, second round? So here round constant will be given to the first round. Okay. These are the values. So this round constant, how it is going to take the round constant values is simply it is going to apply the OR operation, like AND operation in logical AND is there in the same manner. Logical OR operation will be performed between the different round constants, and that will be given. Okay. So finally, the result, whatever the result it is going to produce, will be the output of the absorbing phase. That is, it will give the output as S. So once it is given, that will be given to the squeezing phase. Simply, it generates some output. In squeezing phase, it is not going to perform, initially it is not going to perform any operation. It performs like some 224 bits or 256, 384 bits output will be produced. Then in order to produce another data, more data will be there in the observing after applying them. So whatever the data is there, hash code is there, in order to generate the next hash code, it applies the function again. It is when it applies the iteration function, then it will produce the hash code. So that is the procedure of SHA-3 algorithm. This is SHA-3 algorithm. Any doubts? Yes, all of you answer this question. Yes, if no doubts, we can leave the session after answering the given question, poll question. Thank you. So the answer is both permutation and substitution. Permutation and substitution.